Penguin Random House Audio presents The Unconventionals, How Rebel Companies Are Changing Markets, Hearts, and Minds, and How You Can Too, based on the award-winning podcast. Written and read by Mike O'Toole and Hugh Kennedy. This is the author, Mike O'Toole. They can say that we're crazy, but if it weren't crazy, everybody would be doing it. That's the same thing for all companies. When people say it's a bad idea, that's when you know you should probably do it. Kim Jung, founder, Rumi Spice.
Forward by David Rogers. Do brands still matter in the digital age? It's a puzzling question, but I've been asked it more than a few times as I advise business leaders or as I teach senior executives at Columbia Business School about strategy and leadership in the digital age. It seems obvious to me that brands still matter. Many of the most admired businesses of the digital era, from Zappos to Apple, from Waze to Warby Parker, have clearly built amazing brands that resonate with customers and earn their trust and loyalty. What I think is really driving this question is that the traditional means of building a brand are becoming increasingly irrelevant. You know, add a novel feature or two, call it your unique selling proposition, capture it in a catchy slogan, script a simple story or metaphor, and pay to transmit a consistent message, brand positioning, to a targeted demographic audience. This kind of narrow, unidirectional approach to building brands is simply less and less effective. In a world of networked customers, your potential buyers are constantly connected to information from every digital tool, search, social, reviews, and more, to learn, discover, and make up their own independent minds. Meanwhile, your competitors are using the same data as you, if not better, to reach the same customers at the very moments of maximum interest and intention, to offer their own version of the same message. Why would your pitch win? But all hope is not lost. More and more businesses are finding a different path to win the hearts, minds, and trust of customers. This path doesn't start with another creative ad campaign. Instead, it starts with building a different kind of business, and it drives growth by building a very different kind of relationship with customers. This path may seem unconventional, but it's the path being chosen by more and more successful companies today, across all different industries. Mike O'Toole and Hugh Kennedy have been delving into the world of such unconventional companies for over 6 years now, researching case studies, interviewing company founders, executives, and employees, and digging into their stories to find out what makes them such magnets for devoted customers, employees, and fans. I've had the pleasure to join Mike and Hugh in several episodes of their podcast series, as well as on stage at Columbia Business School's Bright Conference, which I founded over a decade ago, and in ongoing conversations about why and how these unconventional businesses create more value both for customers and their own firms. What I've learned is that today's most dynamic new businesses do two things really well. First, they reinvent their category, whether in terms of the customer experience, the business model, or both. Digital technologies are creating more opportunities for this reinvention every day. Second, these companies articulate an animating mission or purpose, first for their own employees, but then to their external customers as well. When both of these things happen, they spark and feed a third phenomenon. These companies have a different kind of connection with their customers. These customers don't just buy products. They act as ambassadors, advocating for a brand and defending it against criticism. They serve as sounding boards, bringing the customer point of view inside the business. And they volunteer as collaborators, helping to improve and innovate the next step in the business. What Mike and Hugh have done here is dig deeply into these three ideas: category reinvention, animating purpose, and customer collaboration, by exploring the stories of an extremely wide-ranging set of businesses that each illustrate this unconventional path to building a great business with, and not just for, their customers. In the digital age, where every industry is open to transformation, where customers are more connected and empowered than ever before, and where employees and customers alike are looking to engage with brands around shared vision and values, this unconventional path just may become the new normal. I know it is already the path of today's most promising businesses. I hope it is the path for your business as well. David L. Rogers, Faculty Director, Digital Business Strategy and Digital Business Leadership, Columbia Business School. Introduction. What are unconventionals anyway? Where do you look for business wisdom today? Consider this story from a wide-ranging conversation we had with Warby Parker CEO Neil Blumenthal. So I started to design glasses according to the needs and wants of the communities where we were working. Lo and behold, in the same factories where I was manufacturing glasses for people living on less than $4 a day, I would see on the production line next door Marc Jacobs glasses coming off the line and all these major fashion labels. And you discover that there's a disconnect between what it costs to manufacture glasses and what they're being sold for. Warby Parker was about how are we going to transform this industry that's been ripping people off for decades. What makes Warby Parker worth paying attention to? Selling glasses at a lower cost is a small story. A company that people will gladly tell their friends about and a product that people are proud to wear can be a 100-year story. We expect more from companies these days. We want meaning in our work as employees. And we want a story we can believe in as consumers. Warby Parker delivers both by upending conventional business wisdom across the board. Warby Parker questioned core category assumptions. They also measured return and impact differently and reinvented relationships with their employees. In short, they had an agenda to change an outmoded market. In the process, they are blazing a path to a better way of doing business that provides meaning. Meaning that attracts customers, employees, and leaders. So how do you find your change agenda? As marketing professionals with a couple of decades of shared experience in a Cambridge, Massachusetts advertising agency, we wanted to know too. That's why we spent the past 6 years interviewing dozens of entrepreneurs and executives at some of the hottest companies in the world. From Rethink Robotics and Peloton to Everlane and Big Ass Fans. We asked them about the origins of their success, how they built powerful brands, and how they communicated with their customers. We call these companies unconventionals because they turn traditional business practice on its head. We believe they're worth emulating because they've landed on a few simple practices that they all tend to share and that make them so successful. No, it's not about having the most inventive sales force or the best ad campaigns. It's not about a better supply chain or a better use of AI. Instead, reinventing your company, or starting a new one, in an unconventional way is based on three things businesses do that create the most passionate customers. First, these companies uncover Darwinian gaps in the market that demand disruption. And they locate opportunities to shift or even reinvent their markets based on those gaps. More on all this in part one. Second, they define the kind of change they want to drive in the market, change that makes life better for them and their buyers, and craft experiences to help people see the world differently or reconsider traditional behaviors. More on this in part two. Third, they activate and co-create with their crazies, the subset of customers, prospects, thought leaders, and cultural voices who believe in changing the status quo and exert a huge outsized impact on the market. Intrigued? Listen to part three. By the way, we're not talking about change on the level of swap out the tagline on your advertising campaign or increase the discounts on your in-app purchases. Consider the words of poet Mary Oliver, which came to us by way of the Unconventional's guest and Rumi Spice founder, Kim Jung. Tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? This is not the kind of summons that leads one to consider a career as a bank teller. It's a direct pitch to the soul and the gut to make a difference. It's the reason we all admire people who stand up for what they believe in.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.